America is be true to what you said on paper. If I lived in China or even Russia or any totalitarian country, maybe I could understand some of these illegal injunctions. Maybe I could understand the denial of certain basic First Amendment privileges because they haven't committed themselves to that over there. But somewhere I read of the freedom of assembly. Somewhere I read of the freedom of speech. Somewhere I read of the freedom of press. Somewhere I read that the greatness of America is the right to protest far right. And so just as I say we aren't gonna let any dogs or water hoses turn us around, we aren't gonna let any injunction turn us around. Well, I don't know what will happen now. We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now because I've been to the mountaintop. I don't mind. Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've looked over. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you. But I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord.
Happy New Year.
Welcome back to the Dear Yvette Radio Show.
Yeah, welcome back. Long time no see.
Who's back? It's the Minister of Information, Mr. Eminem himself.
Yeah, they ain't get me yet in Pennsylvania, so I was able to come back.
You know what? I officially been off the air for like 3-4 weeks, but let me explain what had happened.
I don't know, because I was getting questions.
Now, my target date to come back was January the 8th, right? But lo and behold, I know you know what happened to me.
Yeah, I know. We already talked about that.
This is the worst flu season in history. And guess what? I was one of those 65 million people that was at the doctor, like, help me, Lord.
Well, you better be glad I have my Michael Jackson mask on sitting up here.
You know what? I'll say I'm about 93%. However, I'm still on meds. I got the best doctor in the world. Shout out to you. Now, Dr. Williams.
Okay, we're talking about flu medication, not mental medication.
You know what? That's why we have this man back. Because,
okay, I'm just trying to understand. Write that down.
He brings the laughs. No, seriously, I was stuck at home.
I know.
Sick as a dog.
I know.
And I had to nice and politely put a sign and say, it's with great sadness that your girl.
Yeah, well, we already told you how I felt about that whole situation. So I'm just leave that where it is.
Lo and behold, right? See, what had happened was I was getting dressed. Figure out what shirt, which pants, what this and So, honey, you know that I rock. This left toe hit that wooden bed.
Like I asked you when you called me, I said, was you rushing? And I said, what you rushing for?
No, I probably was thinking I was really cute. I mean, because that's if you don't think you're cute, who else will?
Well, I'm glad you can admit that.
And okay. I hit that toe, and I was on the ground calling the Lord.
Well, you paid for that cuteness, didn't you?
Almost didn't.
You write that down. You paid for that cuteness.
However, medication is the most amazing thing out here, and I am back representing for such a historic and amazing day. You know what the day is?
Yeah, it's MLK Day.
That's right. It's Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday.
A day of service, a day of reflection.
A day of humanity. What are some of the things that you have been doing today? Did you go to the MLK parade? You can go to I Am Dear Yvette right now and let us know. Also today, before I forget, we're going to have a giveaway towards the end of the show. It's $100 cash, but you have to go to I Am Dear Yvette on Instagram, and you have to be the fifth person that says, hey, Dear Yvette. And we're going to be able to see it. You're going to get your money, and it's a little gas money. It's a little something. That's what we plan on doing.
What was that again?
Hey, if your family, back up. This is for the people.
Okay.
They missed us. They missed me. They missed you. And, it's such a historic day.
You got a lot of stuff. Yeah, you got a lot of stuff that went on these last couple of weeks.
And you know what? I had a whole entire lineup, including guest book and everything, and I had to call everybody and say, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, you know, things happen.
Things
happen.
But
yes, sir.
I am so glad to be back in this chair today. I absolutely missed all you guys out there, and I missed sitting here. So, what you do for MLK Day today?
Well, you saw what I was doing when you came in. I was getting some verbs in.
Yeah.
On a couple of folks online.
Yeah, he was on a rant.
That's what I did on MLK. You know, but no, I really ain't do nothing today because, I just posted online today about reflecting on what I did to help make this day an actual holiday back in 82 when we went and marched on the mall with Stevie, Congressman Connors, Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton. My dad took me.
Wow.
And, I posted online. It just make me remember, like it was yesterday, I just remember Sea of Black Faces and singing Happy Birthday, the intro song.
I put that piece together. Yeah. I thought that speech really, 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 really touches my heart because it's like he had a vision. He said, I might not get there with you.
Yeah.
He's been to the mountaintop. And I that's just an infamous speech that has been in my head since I probably was 7 or 8 years old. And then the Happy Birthday song, it's like, it's not our black version, but you know, when I hear that song, but Stevie sings that song, I always equate it to Martin Luther King. And
The song was written for him.
Yeah.
Because I know, like I said, you know, that day we was out on the mall, we was out marching to make his day actual holiday.
Yeah.
Stevie sung it.
Yeah.
I was on my dad's shoulders, believe it or not.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it was a great day.
Yeah, and guys, I hope that this wasn't a day just for you to lay around the house and say, well, I'm off. Hopefully you've gotten down to the National Mall and visited Dr. King's sculpture that's down there. He has an amazing exhibit down there. I think they did a great job with putting that up there.
Yeah, I have to admit, I haven't been.
Yeah, it's free.
Yeah, it's free. But
it's down on 14th Street. Get out, people.
Yeah.
You got to help teach our kids. But I'm just so excited to be back. I don't even know where to start.
Yeah, because you got a little stuff
catching
on.
Yeah, I got a lot of stuff to try to cram in. Yeah, because, you know, we do the chatterbox.
Yeah, you got to go to Corrala chatterbox right now. You got a bunch of stuff. Yeah.
You know, the last show that I did, I don't know if you watched it, but I have my son's brother's mother on.
Yeah, I saw that was a good show.
So, you know, I got this whole baby mama movement thing going on. We had an amazing time. Shout out to you, Sabrina.
Yeah, that was a good show. I like that show.
When I got back. It's just not us. There's a lot of baby mothers with the same kids' daddy, baby daddies. Yeah. Everybody is just, you know, making stuff happen.
Yeah,
so we're going to talk about that towards the end because I got a picture with Alicia Keys and Mushonda, which is Swiss Beats, daddy.
Is his wife.
Yeah,
one of the amazing producers.
Yeah, his first wife. They say he left Mushonda for Alicia Keys.
But apparently they was having problems before.
I don't recall.
Like that. It's not for us to know.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I don't know, it's a legend.
It's a legend. You know.
Alicia Keys was like, I want him, you know.
Apparently she got him.
You know, he rearranged this whole thing.
He Swiss Beats that.
Swiss Beats. Dropping them beats. All right, let's get into the Chatterbox session. I'm so excited. Even though you guys know I was out sick.
Okay, right? What are we talking about?
So it might be a little old right now, but this is stuff that I felt was important.
Might be new to somebody.
Okay, Oprah Winfrey at the Golden Globe Awards about 2 weeks ago now.
Look at
Lady O.
But we still talking. People still talking about that, though.
That's why I got my black on today. Shout out to you, Oprah. They say Oprah for president. What you think?
You know what? I think Oprah gave a nice speech, and she was feeling it because it's a lot going on, and that's what she does.
Yeah, she gave speech in reference to a lot of the things we've been talking about for weeks.
A lot of stuff.
The little sexual harassment and all the stuff that she said is not more powerful than having your voice. Of course, she was in there with her boo stabbing.
Yeah, you know what? And a voice Stedman been there for 40, 50 years. He ain't going nowhere.
Stedman looked like he just holding on.
But Stedman,
Oprah looked like she getting young. Look at this man. I'm like, when did Stedman go completely? Is that white or gray?
Man, that's
Lord,
that's
Oprah
pepper. That's pepper right there. That's salt and pepper.
Pepper and Oprah is still. Hey. Oprah looked like she about 25.
Hey, Stedman said, look, I ain't coloring nothing. I'm going to just go ahead with it. For real.
Yeah. So, you know, it was a lot of stuff going on with that Me Too stuff. And she basically is applauding, as she said, it's a new day on the horizon. And, we were saying that a couple of weeks ago that, you know, nobody should have to endure what a lot of these females have endured. And I know it to be true.
Well, I don't think nobody, you know. Yeah. I'm not gonna say nobody would make it up, but apparently
at the awards, a lot of the women were wearing all black. That's why I got my black sweat on because I was a little too boopy. So I said, let me cover it up just a little bit.
Yeah.
So time's up. All the women decided to stand up. I think we have a picture. Look at that. Oh, that's all the ladies of the talk.
Eve on that.
Yeah, they said the reason why they rocking that black. You know, time is up. Time to put it out there.
That's Wilson. Wilson, she on the show now?
Oh, no, I guess she was just guest host.
Oh, okay.
Carney Wilson. Yeah. Hey, girl.
Okay.
Yeah, look at E to the V to the E.
Yeah.
Hey, Evie. But anyway, so, you know, it was a great night. I did watch the Golden Globes, even though I was sick on the couch. Yeah,
I watched Oprah's speech.
Yeah.
I just happened to turn and caught her speech.
And all the blogs and all the TV.
Yeah, people,
they were
making a big,
it was
big
something. Then people saying, she don't need to run and she don't need to do this and do that. It was just a mess. The lady ain't even signed up.
She ain't say nothing. All she gave, all she said was her piece on the Me Too. Me Too, that was it,
You out there know if she decides to run, it's a done deal.
I don't know about that.
What?
I don't know if I. Yeah.
You wouldn't get Oprah Winfrey your vote. See, this is why we got to talk.
No, I'd rather for Senator Kamala Harris. Kamala Harris. See,
okay.
Kamala Harris
from the
California.
Cali. Oh, yeah.
I'd rather for her to run.
I do my research.
Yeah, I prefer her.
Yeah.
You know.
Okay.
But if Oprah runs and nobody else, I'm down with Oprah.
But Oprah, if she was president, know what would happen? Think about this. You get a car. We all get a car.
They got an Obama phone. Supposed to give Obama phones away. What you think they did Oprah?
Nobody would have to do nothing because Oprah be running that place like a
kid. Man, I don't know about that.
I don't know how long Stedman will probably be able to hang on.
Man.
8 years?
I don't think Oprah. I don't know if Stedman can do one day. I don't know if he want that headache.
You know, shout out to all the women, you know, here at the Yvette Show. Of course, we got the Minister of Information back. Yeah, I rolled my eyes.
Yeah, I know.
I'm glad
that's why I ain't
paying
no mind to you.
Because you just, you know, you go with my flow. You know, it's like cheek and chong. I can't deny it.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
I can't deny it.
Yeah, but you don't listen. So.
Oh, excuse me. But anyway. Yeah,
there you go. You go.
Okay, but let me share this story with the Me Too thing. And like Oprah said, I applaud the women. It might have taken you 40 years to come out and speak. But what we want to know and what I want to say to this generation is speak out. If you've been offended. Now, let me give you this small thing and then we're going to move right along. Let me share you this story. Back in 2001. That's why I say stuff goes on in so many type of situations, and until you're put in that situation, you officially don't know how to deal with it. Mm-hmm. Back in 2001, I don't know if you're familiar with TGI Friday's restaurant.
Which one?
Well, it was one uptown, right?
Oh, okay.
Okay,
this is back
in my bartending days. You know, I was on and popping down there. Shout out to the Mirage.
Oh, about it.
Up down there. So I said, let me take on a little, because I was working in Mirage at night. And I was like, well, let me see what TGI Friday's got going on during the day.
By the FBI building.
Yeah. So I go down there and bounce down there and put my little application in, okay? Went on in there. One of the general managers happened to be there that day, so I put my application in. He accepted it. He said, we'll give you a call for an interview. 2 weeks later, this interview turned into hashtag Me Too.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, sir.
Was he what?
It turned into hashtag Me Too.
Did he Charlie Rose you?
Well, let me tell you where it happened. Now, there's no gag order on this particular case because, of course, I won it. I am Dear Yvette. And one thing I know is my rights. Mm-hmm. And even back then, I was a young 20-something. I still knew the power that I possessed, right? Mm-hmm. So I get an interview. I go up there. It's probably like 6 or 7 in the evening. Place is crowded and pumping. He takes me over to this amazing little table all set up. Me, in my mind, I'm like, I'm going to get this job. Because a buddy of mine had told me the tips was off the chain during the day.
Well, it was uptown, of course.
Yeah, it was uptown. Yeah. And I'm like, I'm going to get some of them coins, right?
I don't blame him.
So he's like, well, I'm going to go ahead and interview you now. He got the table all set up. I get there. This is no joke. It was a steak sitting there,
what?
A baked potato. Yeah. You know, Friday's got some bomb food.
Yeah, but he
they got them big ribs out right now. They got to get up there.
Yeah, he was going to hire you out.
What?
He's going
to
hire you out.
But me not knowing. So I'm sitting there. I'm saying to myself, you know, this is amazing. A free meal. He slid a little Heineken right over there. Ooh. You know, I was of age because, like I said, you can't be a bartender without being at least 21.
Oh, he was trying to Weinstein you.
I don't know what he was trying to do. However, you know, we sat and we talked, and he was like, where you work, and woo-woo-woo. So we got through the interview. I ended up eating my little free steak.
Oh, my God.
And next thing I know, he slid his little hand over there and was like, yeah, you got the job.
Oh, he was Matt Lauer.
You know, just doing a little. I'm like, what in the Sam Susie sausage?
He was he was Matt Lowering you. That's
he
what he
did
was doing.
Something,
he was
and
Matt
it
Lowering
wasn't good.
You.
It wasn't a good feeling. So I ended up leaving, you know, and he said some inappropriate things.
I bet he did.
You know, and I'm just like, well, look.
Lord Jesus.
This is not funny, and I'm not making this up.
Lord
because
Jesus.
This actually turned into a lawsuit.
I would hope so. I would
you know,
hope
I
so.
Got all the way home, and I thought about it. I said to myself, now, this man had it set up,
steak,
you know, to get me
drinks.
Drunk, feed me, and then, you know, sort of dangle a job in my face. And I thought about it. So I got some amazing attorneys. I called him up, Malin McCool. He said, what? So lo and behold, okay. It was an official lawsuit, and I ended up winning the lawsuit.
I would hope so.
To the tune of $40,000, shout out to me, because I knew my value and I knew my worth. However, they made me sign this paper saying that I would never be allowed to work in TGI Fridays again, basically, in order to give me the money. Now, you know, of course, I had to pay my lawyers, but I still walk with about 36. So, you know, I wasn't mad, you know. I was just trying to get hired.
But right, look here, man.
But I'm thinking about it today. Yeah. Was this a Me Too moment? And why should I not be able to work as a bartender? And, you know, you guys tricked me into signing something to say, you know, I'll take the money and run. However, the joke's on you guys because I hope you learned your lesson from that. They end up paying it out. The general manager I heard was still there. So, you know, is Friday's one of the corporations? Is this going on in all types of businesses and people are just like, let's just pay them out?
Well, that's been the issue. That's been a problem.
It's a problem. And it's gotten to the point where it's been swept under the rug so much and it's just like everyday life. But he still was the manager there. However, I was not a bartender. But I had some coins.
Well, that's all. Like you got justice.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, This is another thing that I miss, moving right along. It was a situation going on with H&M.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Did you see the latest on that?
Yeah, I saw the latest. I think Jacob has some pieces. This is apparently a young king. Somebody, of course, it says coolest monkey in the jungle originally.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
For some type of huge ad that they rolled out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And somebody actually went through IG. I think it's another picture, Jacob. This was some coolest sort of campaign. And
apparently it was a shirt, a mm-hmm. sweatshirt that they only sold over in London.
Yeah.
And apparently they had a young kid, you know, the coolest monkey in the jungle.
Yeah.
Was on the shirt.
Yeah.
And the mother of this child said she saw nothing wrong with that campaign.
Of course not, because she was trying to get them coins.
Yeah. Look, look, I don't knock your hustle.
Yeah.
But.
At what cost?
Now, but the latest is over in Africa, mm-hmm. they have shut down the H&M stores because they have been protesting and destroying the stores.
Wow.
This. Yeah.
So well, you know, here on our side, they basically was like, don't shop at H&M.
Yeah.
You know, I think last week they had like an 80% off sale and folks were saying they was en route.
You know what?
it's crazy.
I think it's an H&M store downtown.
Mm-hmm.
I know when I was thinking about shopping for, you know, Amaya, our daughter.
Yeah.
You know, I was looking at the prices. I'm like, I don't want to go to Target and get the same stuff.
Well, H&M, after all the backlash, they did put out a statement. It's been everywhere. Like I say, I'm about a week behind. You want to read the statement for us, Mike?
But it's still going on, though.
Yeah.
We understand that many people are upset about the image of the child's hoodie. Who we work at H&M can only agree. We deeply sorry the picture was taken, and we regret the actual print. Now, the thing, therefore, we have not only removed the image from our channels, no, they haven't, but also the garment from our product offering. That's not true.
Right. Really?
Now, this statement, when they put it out, they were still selling the shirt overseas.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Now,
I heard about that.
They don't sell. They don't sell it here.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's obviously our routine, you know, haven't, you know, been followed. But my thing is, they put out that statement, but it came back online that they were still selling the shirt over in London.
Wow.
After they put the statement out. Now, I don't know what happened after that, but apparently it was still selling over there. I don't know if it was selling here in the States or not. But,
wow.
I mean, I could put out a statement right now. If I cussed you out, it don't mean I actually regret cussing you out.
Yeah.
You know?
So it remains to be seen how this brand will come back from this. I don't believe for 1 minute, and like we've been hearing some of the chatter, that nobody knew what this campaign was about, you know.
Yeah, but
I think that's bull, because somebody that puts out them coins to run these ads and promote different items, somebody had to sign a check.
This sister gave this great response. She said it had to go from an ad agency to an executive board, executive board to, you know, another committee, and a committee to a person finally signing off on it. So it went through like 4 to 5 stages or a process in order for somebody to agree that was okay to sell in the store.
Yeah.
So for you to be say you, you know, you shocked and outraged that,
you
know, people are offended.
You know, I just say, and this is one thing that celebrities got behind real quick.
Yeah.
And like I say, they pick and choose some things, but things that matter, you know, I respect the fact that they'll get behind it.
Yeah.
I think The Weeknd dropped them with the campaign.
Yeah,
he was doing some things, and somebody else. And you know, so it was just a domino effect.
Yeah.
But however, we hope H&M has learned their lesson, and we'd like to see more diversity. We are all one people. Everybody's bleeding red blood, and that's how I feel about it.
Okay.
Okay, unless you got some green blood, your blood probably yellow.
Yeah, it is.
Moving right along. Now, you know, I was home on the couch. I had, you know, this girl right here, I love her so much. The queen of hip-hop and R&B, Mary J. Blige, finally
got a star.
That walk.
Yeah, you look at Lucas Simrell, Andre Harrell, and Puffy.
She finally got the Hollywood Star Walk of Fame. You got somebody was like, well, Diddy, he all in the video. You know he's going to be down there taking his knee.
But you know what?
Andre Harrell, the original, shout out
Uptown,
to you. That
Uptown,
is legend right there. Uptown Records, you know, yeah. made it happen. They say they heard her demo, and it was just on and popping from yeah. there.
The only person missing is Jeff Reid, who actually found, who discovered Mary J. Blige. Oh, in the mall.
Wow. Yeah, you right.
Jeff
you are
Reid.
Absolutely
yeah.
right.
Jeff Reid.
Yeah, yeah so I thought this was an historic
it's
moment.
About time.
I was pissed that I was home and could not get out and help celebrate.
It's about time.
Because, you know,
I love
she ain't got no more drama.
Thank
she done
yeah.
divorced that man. See how she was at the Golden Globe Awards. Mary got a movie out.
On.
See how yeah. amazing your life could be when you just drop some baggage.
Yeah, did you see that? Did you see that Bama say he needed more money because he went
and
to the hospital and was
the
sick?
Dime, cause the judge
yeah,
told
man, come
he
on.
He wasn't
man.
Absolutely getting a dime. Oh, my God. So we're happy for that. I'm waiting on more music, Mary. Is it like another album?
Well, she's touring right now, right? She's touring.
I don't know.
Yeah, cause
I'm not sure.
She's touring because I know Layla said she had a couple of dates with Mary.
Okay.
So yeah, she's touring
okay.
right now. So
she's probably
yeah.
doing little small shows.
Yeah.
I haven't heard of a big tour.
Yeah.
But this last picture, we're gonna run. Well, actually, it's one more. But this one is what I was speaking about, the baby mama movement.
Uh-oh.
Your kids, even though you have children by different, mothers and they all share a parent, whether it's a mother or the father.
Yeah.
It's a movement going on. It's called No More Baby Mama Drama. How about that?
It shouldn't be.
That's Mushonda and Alicia Keys hanging out. You know, this is what real women do. This is what the Yvette Show is about.
Okay.
Supporting women, acknowledging the fact that, yeah, it might be a little drama sometime, but if you just keep in mind that it's in the best interest of the kids.
Yeah.
And I mean, just go and sign me up as the poster.
It's not,
you know,
yeah, it's not about the men or women anymore.
Yeah, it's not
Once
about
the kids
it.
Come, I've always said this.
It's not about it.
Yeah,
and we gotta wrap this chatterbox up because yeah. guess who we got in the building today?
You know who we got?
Angelo Escobar.
Yeah, that's right, Angelo
yeah.
Escobar.
He's here, Escobar.
Yeah.
You gotta say it, Escobar.
I'm taking Spanish right now on my phone, so I'll be able to do that better in a couple more weeks.
Yeah, so he's in the building. He's going to have an amazing performance. We're going to do a little interview with him.
All right.
And he's going to show us what he got. You know, mm-hmm, the Yvette Show is all about promoting local, up-and-coming artists. If you are somebody that's out here passionate and you want to do your thing, hey, come on, use our platform.
There you go.
Right, I'm trying to get you to rap.
No. My rapping days are done in 1992. Yeah, no, the only thing I can rap is a present. That's it.
Okay, you know our boy Will Felice Art, right?
Oh, yeah.
I'm getting ready to unveil that. I don't even know if I sent that to Jacob. Oh, this is my new logo, guys. Hey, come on, Mike. Yeah, you know that.
I ain't clapping for that.
You know
mess.
That look like me, right?
No, it ain't nagging enough.
I was completely dressed like that a couple of weeks ago, and it was so shocking. This boy's just so amazing.
Yeah, he did another picture. I think he did a photo of somebody's, I don't know if it was his daughter or somebody.
Yeah, his daughter.
Yeah,
his
it was a beautiful
girl.
Picture.
That
yeah.
was beautiful.
It looked like a
Facebook.
Camera picture.
You can check
yeah.
Will Felice art out
yeah,
on
man.
Facebook. He will
amazing.
Be here probably in about a month. You know,
amazing.
He's somewhere sketching as we
yeah,
speak.
Yeah.
Shout out to you, Will. But that is it for the Chatterbox session. Ask Dear Yvette, we will run that next week because we really don't have time today because we want to sit down and chat with Angelo
yeah,
and check out,
yeah, mm-hmm,
you know,
yeah, see
what he got
about.
For
yeah.
us. I think he's going to perform two songs. I believe he's doing a song called Too Many Friends. Oh, I could smell
I
a hit when I see
it. I can understand Too Many Friends.
I'm hoping he has too many friends with
yeah,
our
believe,
force
yeah.
today.
But
it's the Dear Yvette Show. You got your boy Minister Information back. Crazy as ever. Listen to visionlive.com. We'll be right back.
Everybody's welcome. Yeah. Come on down to a D-Vet show. Every Monday at 7 p.m. Ooh. y'all, don't waste no time. Come on down to the D-Vest show every Monday, 7 p.m. Okay, it's your boy Lico. I'm rolling with Yvette. And listen, Vision, you heard. Holla at y'all. Peace.
Guys, welcome back to the Dear Yvette Radio Show. We got a guest over here. He's sipping his water right now, but we have a lot to get into. Give it up, guys. Please welcome Angelo Escobar. He is here. Welcome to the Dear Yvette Show.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I mean, one thing about you, it's like, you know, I tried to book you a couple of weeks ago. Your cousin had told me, so I actually do my research. So I actually checked you out, and I said, you know what? He got to come on this show.
Thanks, man.
So I thank you so much for following up and blessing us today.
Man.
So, Angelo, tell us what it is that you do. Tell them. They want to know.
Well, I'm an up-and-coming artist.
Okay.
From the DMV area.
DMV?
Yes.
Okay.
I rap, produce, you know, shoot videos.
Wow.
Kinda like do it all.
That's what's up. I've been tracking you actually on Instagram. You can always hit him up, Angelo Escobar 58 on IG. you are absolutely amazing. And that's one of the things that I do on this show is to showcase. I take my platform and showcase up and coming artists such as yourself.
Appreciate
people that
it.
Are dedicated, passionate. I saw that in your music. I could smell a hit. One of the songs that you're performing today is Too Many Friends. And I just said to myself, oh, this is definitely going platinum, gold, whatever color. It'll go purple. You know, that's my favorite color. But, of course. But I am so glad. So we're going to chat with you. You're going to be performing two songs today, right?
Right.
Okay. You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay.
I'm
and this is your first live performance, though.
Yes, it is.
You just snuck that in because I'm shocked. I am honored to have you perform live right here.
I'm honored to be on the show.
Thank you. So, okay, Angelo, how long have you been performing?
Actually started performing and being involved musically in class since I was 12 years old.
Okay. All right, so it's sort of inside. Passion, yeah, basically. Gifted. Yeah, I can tell that in an artist's delivery. You know, when you're out there rapping, singing, or whatever you do, it's your delivery. And I definitely believe that you have that.
That's the importance.
Why I said we want him on the show to talk to us. So what's the inspirations? What's the inspiration around some of the songs that you have? Like, do you write because of the way you're feeling? Or
definitely. Music is about emotions.
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah.
Everything that I rap about, that's just how I feel. I always try to be honest and humble with my music and, you know, speak from my heart.
Yeah. Yeah. And I you know, I got that, especially Too Many Friends, because I went through a situation this past weekend, honey, and I thought somebody was my friend, but they really wasn't. And, you know, it really broke me down because when you have too many friends, sometimes the reasoning behind your relationship could get lost. So that's why that song, I said, this thing right here is a hit. It definitely is. Tell us your opinion on the hip-hop community.
Well, the hip-hop community as of right now, there's really no complaints. I kind of like it. I take it back. I love it because, you have young kids and you just have people that's just being creative and you can't take that from them because that's a part of them. So,
yes. And every city, every, you know, some people try to give our youth today some bad rap. We have some of the most amazing, talented, gifted youth. They just not on the corner. Yeah, they probably smoking their little herb, you know, but they ain't bothering nobody. But at the same time, they have gifts. They're very passionate, such as yourself. And that's what I want this platform to continue to do, is showcase that. Right. You know, because it's not every day that we see that side. You know, this young man, you know, yeah, his pants might be hanging down, but this boy is gifted, and he has a dream. Shout out to Martin Luther King, you know.
Shout out.
Okay, now, what songs will you be performing for us today?
Well, I will be performing Too Many Friends.
Too Many Friends. Okay, tell us about Straight Out the District.
Well, Straight Out the District is basically my single that I'm working on, collaborating with a good friend of mine named Creole the Z.
Wow.
You know.
Shout out,
Creole. Producer. Mm-hmm. It's soon to come out in March or early April. I haven't really set a release date for it, but, you know, it's definitely in the makings.
Okay. Wow. Mm-hmm. That's what I like to hear. And make sure that I get a copy and I could make sure I promote your EP. What's the title of the EP again?
Title is going to be called No Nuts, No Glory.
Okay, No Nuts, No Glory. That's right, because there's a bunch of nuts up out here. No glory, you know. Right. And what are all social media platforms? Are you on, I know you're on IG.
I'm on IG, I'm on Twitter. Facebook. Okay. Everything is the same.
Now, Angelo, your music, is it on SoundCloud?
Yes, or? SoundCloud.
Okay, give us the information behind that.
Well, basically, you just type in Angelo Escobar on SoundCloud. You'll find a song called Glow that I did with Creole the G.
Okay.
A song, Too Many Friends, I did with a producer that goes by PK on the Beats from Miami.
Okay, yeah. Miami. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Kind of just networking, man.
Yeah, that's how you do it. Yeah. So, where do you want your career? You know, are you doing it for celebrity, or are you doing it because this is your craft and you're just passionate?
Basically doing it because this is my life. I feel like if I'm not doing music, you know, I'm dying.
Right.
So, I mean, you can honestly say it's just for the craft. I would love for the mainstream.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong.
Yeah, it'll come because, you know, you got the right music and it will come. And I am so grateful that you're doing your very first live performance right here on the Dear Yvette Show. Angelo Escobar is in the building, guys. We're going to go to a quick break because he needs to get his... You ready to go, right?
I'm born ready.
You know how we do it. It's Dear Yvette Show. ListenVisionLive.com. Angelo Escobar is coming up next. Don't log off.
All right, welcome back to the D Vet Show. Give it up for my man Angelo Escobar, who
got
across the stage. Give it to him.
I got too many friends right now. I don't need you for a friend. I got a million friends right now.
Man, it's all day, every day, man. Angelo Escobar, you hear me? LD General. Hope y'all ready, man.
Don't you look at me, man. I'm serious than cancer, boy.
Angelo Escobar. Yeah.
Ain't no squares in my circle. Circle smaller than a dot. Mama said, what's the fake love? Cause you think it's there, stab you in the back. Don't think you understand who I am. Got big boy like tug of war. If we go to war, we can go to war. My head is at your door, what did you score? Now I'm gonna fuck with you, niggas. No, 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 no. All you fuck niggas, bozos, transformers, turn the popos. Man, nigga, go solo. Yeah, I'm loyal to my hustle, nigga. Only person that was there for me since day one was the struggle, nigga. Swear them broke days made me. They wasn't fucking with me back then. So I went and made some new friends. Mr. Jackson, Mr. Granny Ben. My pocket's real, real chunky. Boy, you looking real, real bummy. You should be focused on money. Get up off your ass and go and get it, nigga. Yeah, I got too many friends. I don't need no new associates. Best friends with their presidents. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Jackson, that's my BFF. Mr. Brain, that's my BFF. Mr. Ben, that's my BFF. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, I don't got too many friends. I don't need no new associates. I'm best friends with their presidents. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Jackson, that's my BFF. Mr. Brain, that's my BFF. Mr. Ben, that's my BFF. Yeah, 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 yeah. All my haters feel salty, yeah. Mad cause your boy saucy, yeah. Hit the pussy one time, after that I ain't texting the code, yeah. Niggas claim they want my life, yeah. Why you pussy keep stalling, yeah. High in the sky like Southwest Airline, boy, name fuck. Can't put my phone down, swear to God, the money just keeps going. I ain't told less bitch, ain't got time to be wasting. Jesse owns when it come to check the paper, Lord knows I ain't pasting. When I was down, yeah, they loved me. But now I'm up, yeah, they hate me. Gamble with your life, fuck nigga, no casino, casino. Mom been hot like Latino, garbage gets dressed up like burritos. I got my hustle down pack, keep my shit tighter than a pair of Speedos. I'm all these chips, call me Frito. Them dollar signs, my amigo. Yeah, I got too many friends. I don't need no new associates. I'm best friends with their presidents. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Jackson, that's my BFF. Mr. Brand, that's my BFF. Mr. Ben, that's my BFF. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, I got too many friends. I don't need no new associates. I'm best friends with their presidents. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Jackson, that's my BFF. Mr. Grant, that's my BFF. Mr. Ben, that's my BFF. Yeah. Out the district.
Some water for this man.
Yeah, I'm straight out the district. No fees be my trenches. Well, they ain't showing no love. That's so I'm strapped with that glicky. Ain't no trust in these niggas. They transform into snitches. I'm about that almighty dollar. Put all my faith in these bitches. Yeah, I'm straight out the district. Lord, fees be my trenches. Well, they ain't showing no love. That's so I'm strapped with that glicky. Ain't no trust in these niggas. I'm about that almighty dollar.
Angelo Escobar.
Yeah. 5-8 be my residence. Where they skate for them presidents. Every man for himself. So showing love is irrelevant. My young niggas stay ruthless. They throw you a party. Put up on two of them molly. Shoot, kill everybody. My granddad was a gangster. He told me all that he know. He showed me more than principles in the blueprint of the gold. Take a look at my eyes. Better witness this pain. Me going against the grain is like throwing dirt on this lane. My people's rather than rolled out. Man, fuck them, it's cool. With what you do, them niggas flat moves. Making this you. But I'm a stand up guy. So I ain't ducking no hiding. Wayne Gretzky on this ice. With this thick boy flying. Yeah, I'm straight out the district. No fees be my trenches. Where they ain't showing no love. Best so I'm stabbed with that glicking. Ain't no trust in these niggas, cause they transform into snitches. I'm about that almighty dollar, put all my faith in these bitches. Yeah, I'm straight out the district. No fees be my trenches. Well, they ain't showing no love, so I'm strapped with that glicky. Ain't no trust in these niggas, cause they transform into snitches. I'm about that almighty dollar, put all my faith in these bitches. I'm just here for this paper so I can feed all my babies. Interfere with my profit, you gon' be pushing up days. All the fuckboys, they love me, cause I'm a product of the 80s. And all these fuckboys, they hate me, I've been exposing them lately. I'm sick and tired of these niggas, the way they rap in my city. All these lame ass, clown ass niggas, you feel me? LDEB. LDE be the name. I'm here to get niggas hell like I was birthed in the flame. My mama think them drugs got me acting crazy deranged. Since the day my daughter died, I just ain't been the same. Yeah, I been labeled a menace, but I ain't talking about old dog. I'm straight out the district. The world against me, the fuck them all. North feet be my trenches. Well, they ain't showing no love. That's so I'm strapped with that glicking. Ain't no trust in these niggas. Transform into snitches. I'm about that almighty dollar. Put all my faith in these bitches. Yeah, I'm straight out the district. North feet be my trenches. Well, they ain't showing no love. That's so I'm strapped with that glicking. Ain't no trust in these niggas. Cause they transform into snitches. I'm about that almighty dollar. Put all my faith in these bitches.
Angelo Escobar, man, you hit me. Yeah.
Hey, good job, Angelo. Great job.
Where you from now?
Oh,
wow.
Well.
Feast, man. 58.
Well, shout out to everybody into the E.
Roll, baby.
Yes. So, wow.
East Calvary. East Calvary dwellers, man.
Yeah, when you play this back on YouTube, you're going to see me losing it over too many friends. That's absolutely amazing.
Yeah, I had to close my eyes so I could hit a nice wordplay.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Yeah, no doubt.
You know what? We're going to keep an eye on you. And once that EP comes out, we want to make sure you come back. You have a new home here. You're already
keep
familiar
on,
with Listen Vision.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, you know, I thank you so much, Angelo, and I wish you the best. You can check him out, Angelo Escobar, on Instagram. Hey,
stay true
on
to yourself.
IG, too. And IG, Twitter, and
Twitter.
Facebook,
yeah.
Too.
You very weird basis.
Stay true.
It's the Dirty Vet Show, ListenVisionLive.com. See you guys next week. Mwah, right. Love y'all. Yeah.
Everybody's welcome. Yeah. Come on down to a deal.
every Monday at 7 p.m.